Very good morning to one and all. In last class, up to the last classes, we seen the linear applications of our operational amplifiers. Those are nothing but we can operate our op amp as an inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier, summer, subtractor, and also integrator and differentiator. All those things are the linear applications of our operational amplifiers. Today we are going to see about the non-linear applications of our operational amplifier. The first non-linear application of our operational amplifier is a comparator. So today we are going to see about the concept of comparators. Okay, what is meant by a comparator? How can we design a comparator with help of our operational amplifier? The concept of comparator is only related to the operational amplifier in our subject, in our unit. Okay, so what is meant by a comparator? Okay, the name itself, a comparator is a device which compare the two different input signals available to the input terminals of the operational amplifier. If you see the definition, the op amp operational amplifier, the op amp comparator compares an analog voltage levels with the another analog voltage levels, that is difference voltage. Okay, if you we know very well the operational amplifier having two input terminals. One is inverting input terminal and another one is non-inverting input terminal. So we have to give two different signals to the two input terminals of our operational amplifier. Okay, so this op amp or the comparator circuit will compare the two input signals which we are applying to the input terminals and will produce an output signal. That output signal having the magnitudes of magnitudes of either high or low. Okay, the output of comparator having two states, which may be high state or low state, which is depends upon the input signal or comparison procedure of the input signal. So I again repeat that what is meant by a comparator? A comparator or an operational amplifier comparator compares one analog voltage. That one analog voltage is applied to the one terminal, one input terminal of our operational amplifier, with the another input voltage that is applied to the another terminal of our non-inverting terminal of our operational amplifier. These two input signals are compared with the help of our comparator and produces an output signal. That output signal having only two states, those are maybe a high state or low state, which is depends upon comparison. Okay, so our comparator, our operational amplifier designed comparator will always compare two input signals and produces an output signal. Okay, but the output signal is not an analog signal. The operational amplifier comparator here works with the two analog input signals, but it does not produce an analog output. Okay, all the applications before the comparator's concept, whatever it may be, an integrator, differentiator, or inverting amplifier, non-inverting amplifier, all those will produce analog outputs at the output terminal. But our comparator or non-linear applications of our operational amplifiers will doesn't produce an analog outputs. Okay, the output. మైక్స్ ని మ్యూట్ లో పెట్టుకోవటం అలవాటు చేసుకోండి, స్పీకర్స్ ని. ఓకే, లేకపోతే కామ్ గా అయినా ఉండండి, అది డిస్టర్బెన్స్ కదా క్లాస్ మొత్తానికి. ఓకే, సో అవర్ నాన్ లీనియర్ అప్లికేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆపరేషనల్ యాంప్లిఫైయర్, especially the comparator will produces a output. That output is a digital output, means which consisting of logic 1 and logic 0, or high or low outputs. So our comparator will compare the two different analog signals which is available at the input terminals and produces an output signal. That output signal having two states, those are maybe high state or low state. Okay, we have high state or low state. Okay, so we are applying two input signals. In these two input signal, one is our actual input signal and other thing is the reference signal, because of we are going to do the comparison operation. Okay, so the meaning of comparison is we have to compare a signal with respect to some another reference signal. So one of the signal applied to the input terminals of our operational amplifier is reference signal. One signal is the reference signal and another signal is the actual analog input signal. So the actual analog input signal which we are applying, that will be compared with the reference signal. We have to apply one reference signal to the one terminal and apply actual signal to the another terminal. Both will compare, okay, or the actual signal is compared with the reference signal and produces a output. That output may be either high or low states. Only two states will be present at the output. That two states are either high or low operations. Okay, so this is our simple operational amplifier with five terminals. Two are input terminal and this is the output terminal. These two are biasing voltage terminals, positive VCC and negative VEE. Both the values of VCC and VEE are in equal in magnitude. That's why I mentioned that it has positive VS and negative VS. These are biasing voltages. Okay, so if you like to work our operational amplifier as a comparator, we just directly give the input signal and the reference signal to the input terminals of our operational amplifier. And this operational amplifier will perform the comparison operation. Okay, in that comparison operation, it will produce the output, that is V naught is equal to AOL into V2 minus V1. We know very well the output is always directly proportional to the difference of input voltages. What are the input voltages here? V1 and V2. So V0 is directly proportional to V2 minus V1. But if you remove the directly proportionality, you can replace with a gain constant value. So open loop gain of our operational amplifier is AOL. So output is equal to gain into difference of input voltages. V0 is equal to AOL into V2 minus V1. This AOL into V2 minus V1 value is either high or low, which is depends upon the comparison process or input and reference signals. So V1 is the actual signal and V2 is the reference signal. Let us assume, or you can assume V2 is the actual signal or V1 is the reference signal. If V2 is greater than V1, V2 minus V1 value is positive value. The difference of input and output voltages is positive. So the output voltage is also positive. That positive value is positive saturation, okay, V saturate value. So if the difference of two input signals, that is actual signal and reference signal, is positive, the comparator will produce the positive saturation output, that is logic high. Okay, if difference between two input signals is negative, if V2 is less than V1, V2 minus V1 value is negative and it will produce a negative saturation value, that is low, logic low. So how the op amp will produce either positive saturation value or negative saturation value? Let me see. We know very well the gain of our operational amplifier is, I will take a pen. The gain of operational amplifier is AOL. Okay. An operational amplifier, if you operate our operational amplifier in open loop position, the open loop gain of ideal operational amplifier is infinite. So the open loop gain of our op amp is infinite value. So what is voltage, output voltage of our operational amplifier or a comparator circuit is V0 is equal to AOL into V2 minus V1. The value of AOL is infinite here. Okay, and infinite into V2 minus V1. Here in the comparison process, there is two possibilities. We can get V2 minus V1 value is a positive value, or V2 minus V1 value as negative value because of comparison process. If V2 voltage or voltage applied to the non-inverting terminal value is greater than the reference signal value or V1 value, okay, because of we are giving an analog signals, that analog signals are time varying signals. Let us assume I will apply an alternate signal like this, okay, to the V2 or non-inverting terminal, and I will apply a constant DC supply of some 2 volt, 1 volt, whatever it may be, a constant DC supply to the non-inverting terminal. Okay, so in every instant the operational amplifier will compare the V2 signal and V1 signals. The V2 signal is varying alternatively, positive negative peaks like this. Okay, at initial instant V2 value is less than V1 value, but if you goes with the time, after some time period V2 value is greater than V1 value. If time is goes on increasing, at another instant of time again V2 value is less than V1 value. So this comparison process is goes on continuous. If V2 is greater than V1, okay, this V2 minus V1, difference of V2 minus V1 signal is positive because of V2 is more than V1 value. Okay, another possibility is also there, that is, if V2 value, input voltage value, is less than the reference voltage value V1, what should be the difference of V2 minus V1? That is negative. So instead of this V2 minus V1 place, we can get a positive term or a negative term. If positive term is multiplied with the infinite, we get a positive infinite value as the output of our comparator. Or if a negative term is multiplied with the infinite value, we get a negative infinite value as the output. But we can't get an infinite value as the output. Okay, infinite is for an ideal conditions. In practical conditions, this infinite value is replaced with some maximum value. We can get a positive maximum value or a negative maximum values. Okay, either we can get a positive maximum value or a negative maximum value. That positive or negative maximum values are called as saturation values. We get a positive voltage saturation values, SAT, a positive voltage saturation, or we can get a positive voltage saturation value or a negative voltage saturation value. And always this saturation value, either positive saturation value or a negative saturation value, is equal to the biasing voltages whatever we are applying at these terminals. I think these terminals are 4 and 7, I think. Pin 4, pin 7. This is pin 2. This is pin 3. Okay, and this is pin 5, I think. Okay, so we are applying an external biasing voltages to our operational amplifier. Those are plus VCC and negative VEE. We already know that the magnitude of plus VCC and negative VEE is same in value. Okay, that's why I'm replacing that value as VS, biasing voltages, or saturation voltages, whatever it may be. So our comparator will produce as either a positive saturation value or negative saturation value depends upon comparison value or depends upon magnitude of V2 minus V1 value. If V2 minus V1 value is positive, it will produce a positive saturation value. If V2 minus V1 is negative, it will produce a negative saturation value. How can we get positive and negative values? By comparing V1 and V2 signals. If V2 magnitude is greater than V1 magnitude, V2 minus V1 is positive and will produce a positive saturation value. If V2 value is less than V1 value due to comparison process, V2 minus V1 is the negative value, it will produce a negative saturation value. This is a simple working principle of our comparator. Always the comparator will produce either a positive saturation value, that is in our digital language, high magnitude is high level of magnitude, or it can produce a negative saturation value in our digital language. Okay, digital language, that negative saturation value is called as low value or low signal. So the output of comparator is always either high value or low value. In between, there is no output voltage present in between high or low values. Either it may be high or low. If you see this is, okay, the output may be high value or output may be low value. Output may be high value, output may be low value. This process will continue, depends upon the magnitudes of two input voltages which we are applying. Okay, if voltage magnitude V2 is greater than V1, we get this positive saturation voltage value. V positive saturation voltage value. Okay. If the input voltage value is less than our comparison voltage value, we get a negative saturation value like this. Up to the voltage V2 is less than V1. Okay, this is the time period of V2 is greater than V1. This is the time period of V2 is less than V1. And again, this is the time period of V2 is greater than V1. So during this interval of time, voltage magnitude V2 is greater than V1 value. During this interval of time, V2 magnitude is less than V1 value. So this is the concept of our comparator. So the comparator will produce the output signal. That output signal having two states, either logic high or logic low, or positive saturation value or negative saturation values like this. Okay, so this is the concept of our comparator. Okay, so as per our discussion, our comparator is a device which can be manufactured with our operational amplifiers, and it compares the two input signals. In two input signals, one is our required signal and another thing is the reference signal. By comparing these two input signals, it will produce a output signal. That output signal having two states only, that is maybe a high state or low state. High state is a positive saturation value, low state is negative saturation value. And you remember this, you can produce zero state in place of negative saturation value. Okay, if you give a VS voltage, positive VS voltage, this is the pin 7 and this is the pin 5. If you give positive VS value here and if you give a zero voltage value here, then we get a positive saturation value and zero values as the output. Or if you give a positive saturation value and a negative saturation values, we can get a positive saturation and negative saturations at the output. Or if you give a positive saturation value and zero value, we can get positive saturation and zero values as the output. Nothing but high and low outputs. Instead of getting a zero signal, a zero level, instead of instead of negative saturation value, you just give a zero voltage, or you can connect this pin 5 to the ground directly, then it will produce high and low signals of magnitude 1 and 0. But here magnitude is +1 and -1. The magnitude of the output of this specified comparator is +1 and -1. Okay, if you want to replace the -1 with the zero value, you can directly connect this VS, negative VS, to the ground, or negative VS value as 0, then we get high and low low states as 1 and 0 instead of positive V saturation and a negative saturation. Okay, so this is the concept of our comparators. Okay, next, types of comparators. The comparator circuits can be classified into two types depending upon the input signals which we are applying to the input terminals of our operational amplifier. Depends upon the signal which we are applying to the input terminals of our operational amplifier, the comparators can be classified into two types. Those are positive voltage comparator and a negative voltage comparator. Okay, this positive voltage comparator is also called as non-inverting comparator. Positive, what is meaning of positive? Non-inverting. So the positive voltage comparator is also called as non-inverting comparator circuit, and negative voltage comparator is called as inverting comparator circuit. We know very well negative means inverting. Okay, so the comparators can be classified into two types. Those are non-inverting comparator and inverting comparators, or the another names are positive voltage comparators or positive voltage comparators and a negative voltage comparators. So if you see the first configuration of our comparators, that is positive voltage comparator or a non-inverting voltage comparator. The another name of positive voltage converter is non-inverting comparator. Okay, so in this non-inverting comparator or positive voltage comparator, we have to apply the input signal to the positive terminal of the operational amplifier. If you see, this is an operational amplifier. Okay, this is an operational amplifier. This is non-inverting terminal, this is inverting terminal. Okay, so we have to give the input signal to the positive terminal, that is called as non-inverting comparator or positive voltage comparator. And the another inverting terminal is fed to the reference voltage, the comparing voltage. So in the concept of non-inverting comparator or positive voltage comparator, we have to give input voltage to the positive terminal and reference voltage to the negative terminal. And you remember, in the concept of comparator, generally the comparators are open loop operational amplifiers configuration, or it may be a positive feedback configuration. Before this concept, we discussed several concepts related to the operational amplifier. In all the concepts, we are using a negative feedback. The output is connected to the negative terminal, that is called as negative feedback concepts. What we discussed up to this, before this comparators concept, all are negative feedback operational amplifiers. But in the concept of comparators, generally the comparators are open loop circuits or a positive feedback circuits, because of the positive feedback will improve the gain value. Here the intention is we have to improve the gain value. That improved gain value will reach the output as saturated value. Negative feedback application is to reduce or to maintain the gain value, to maximize the gain value up to some mark value, the application of negative feedback. But the positive feedback is increasing more and more gain value. So increasing more and more gain value will cause to produce the saturation outputs. So because of getting saturation outputs, nothing but infinite values of outputs, we have to use our operational amplifiers as open circuits or a positive feedback circuits. Remember this thing, always the op amps used in comparators are either open loop connection or positive feedback connection only. Positive feedback connection only. So if you go with the concept of positive voltage comparator, here in the concept, the input voltage is applied to the positive terminal and reference voltage is applied to the negative terminal. Okay, here the reference voltage, we can extract this reference voltage from VCC value. We can connect, or we can use the reference value from VCC value, or we can directly connect some voltage source as reference voltage to this non-inverting terminal. Either we can connect the reference voltage directly to this inverting terminal, or you can fetch this reference voltage value from VCC value also, because of VCC is the input voltage which is applied to our offset pins, biasing pins. This may be, I think, pin 4 and pin 7, or maybe pin 7 and pin 4, whatever it may be. Okay, so for pin 4 we are applying VCC value. Okay, we can extract the reference value from VCC value by using two resistances like this. Maybe let us assume this is as resistance R1, this is as resistance R2. So the VCC value is again applied to our both the resistors V1, both the resistors R1 and R2. So the connection of both the resistances R1 and R2 will work like as a potential divider. So this entire VCC value is divided across this resistance R1 and resistance R2. If you maintain the values of resistances R1 and R2 are in equal magnitude, that is R1 is equal to R2, this total voltage VCC value is equally divided across the resistance R1 and R2. Okay, so the voltage across the resistance R2 is half of the VCC value, 1/2 times of VCC value. So what is reference voltage? Reference voltage value is half of the VCC value. We can maintain the reference voltage as 1/2 times of VCC value, or you can vary this reference value by varying the values of R1 and R2. If you maintain R1 and R2 values are in equal magnitude, it will be half of the reference value, or you can maintain different values, then we get the reference voltage as R2 divided by R1 plus R2 times of R1 plus R2 times of VCC value. Okay, R1 into R2 times of VCC value because of voltage division rule. From voltage division rule, the voltage across this resistance is nothing but our reference voltage. That reference voltage value is equal to the resistance R2 divided by total resistance R1 plus R2 into VCC value. If you maintain R1 and R2 values as equal, this is 2 R2 get cancelled, 1/2 times of VCC. So we get half of the voltage, half of the biasing voltage as the reference voltage here. Here the two resistors are here. The connection of two resistances in series is help to divide the voltage or produces a reference voltage to the inverting input terminal. Okay, and the non-inverting terminal is fed to our input voltage. So the comparison process is continued here. What is input voltage? The input voltage is triangular wave, which is shown in this figure. The input voltage waveform is a triangular waveform like this. And the reference voltage we discussed already from these formulas. The reference voltage value is exactly half of the biasing voltage value VCC, because of we are using same magnitude of resistances as a potential divider. Okay, so the reference voltage is half of the VCC value. So if you see the comparison procedure, we already discussed the comparator will produce either a positive saturation value, and a negative saturation value. Okay, so if you see the circuit diagram, what is positive saturation value? The positive saturation value is nothing but voltage applied to our biasing terminals. So the positive saturation value is VCC here. Okay, and what is negative saturation value? Negative saturation voltage value is the voltage applied to the another biasing terminal. Here the another biasing terminal is grounded. Okay, another biasing terminal is grounded. So negative saturation value is 0 volts. So we can produce an output that is VCC value or a zero value. At output we can get only two logics, that is high value, that high magnitude value is equal to the VCC value, or low magnitude value, that low magnitude value is zero value. So this is high value, this high magnitude value is positive saturation value or positive VCC value, or we can get low value, this low value as zero value. This is VCC value. High value is equal to VCC value. Low value is equal to the zero value. Okay. So let me see how the positive VCC and zero values will produce at the output of our operational amplifier. Okay. So I will erase all these things. Okay, so what is the input signal applied to our non-inverting terminal? Is a triangular signal like this. What is reference signal is, which is VCC by 2 times. Okay, this is signal. So we go with the concept of comparison. From this instant up to this instant, the input voltage value, up to this instant, the input voltage value is less than the reference signal value, right? The input signal value is less than the reference signal value. Means the input signal value is less than the reference signal value will give us a negative difference. The input signal value is less than reference signal value will produce a negative output. Okay. This negative output will produce a zero magnitude. We already discussed V input here is, I think V input is V1 expression is less than V2 value. Okay. Will cast V2 minus V1 value as negative. Okay, the negative output will produce a negative saturation value or zero voltage value. So up to the first interval of time, the input voltage value is less than reference voltage value, which will produce a zero voltage. From next interval of time period, from this instant, okay, from this time period to this time period, the input voltage value is greater than the reference voltage value. So here the input voltage value is greater than the reference voltage value, means we get a positive output signal. That positive output signal is positive saturation value or VCC value. That saturation value is VCC value. So it will produce a high voltage signal, with the magnitude of VCC, which will produce a VCC voltage like here. This is positive saturation value. Here we can get a negative saturation value. The negative saturation value here is 0 volts. So we get a zero voltage up to this interval of time. From this interval of time to this instant, we get a positive VCC value or positive saturation value. And after this instant to up to this instant, the input voltage value is again less. Input voltage value is again lesser than the reference voltage value. So again, we get a zero voltage as the output voltage. So this process will continue. Okay, this comparison process will continue and produces a respective zero high signals like this. So this comparison process is continue until the availability of input signals and produces output signal. That output signal having two states, either logic high, positive saturation value, positive VCC value, or low, that is zero voltage. Only the output consisting of positive VCC and zero magnitudes. Other than these two states, we don't have any external voltage levels. We have only two voltage levels, positive VCC and zero voltage level, like this as shown in the figure. So all the voltage or output voltage magnitude is depends upon input voltage magnitudes. If the input signal voltage is greater than the reference signal voltage, we can get a positive saturation value, positive peak value like this. In our non-inverting operational amplifier, positive operational amplifier, if the input voltage is less in magnitude as compared to the reference magnitude, we get a zero as output. We get zero output. Okay. So these are the things related to the concept of non-inverting operation. Non-inverting comparator or positive voltage comparator. And we also can analyze the circuit operation with the different signals also. Okay, let me analyze the entire configuration with an alternating signal. Okay, with a sinusoidal signal. So let me take input signal as a sinusoidal signal. I'm taking the input signal as an alternating signal like this. Okay, so this is our input signal, V input signal. And I will take the reference signal of voltage, some 1 volt. Okay, this is the reference signal VR. Okay, if you see the output up to this instant of time period, the input voltage value is less than the reference value. Up to this instant value, this instant of value, the input voltage magnitude is less than the reference voltage magnitude. So the output is zero here. From this instant to this instant, I will represent with the dotted lines. From this instant of time to this instant of time, V input voltage is greater than the reference voltage, which will produce a high output voltage or saturation output voltage like as shown here. Okay, from this instant to again this instant, the input voltage value is less than our reference voltage value, which may produce a zero voltage like this. After this instant, again same thing will repeat, and which produces a positive signal like this up to this instant. So the same procedure will continue, okay, up to the availability of input signals. The output signal is produced like this. So this is the concept of our comparator, positive voltage comparator or non-inverting comparator. We can do this operation. We can do this operation with any signals. Okay, ramp signal, square signal, triangular signal, whatever it may be. But the two signals are necessary. One is the input signal and another thing is the reference signal. By using this reference signal and input signals, we can do this comparison operation, okay, and will produce the output as like this. Okay, So this is the working of our positive voltage comparator concept. Okay. Okay, sir, I am going to tell you how to do this.